Hello, hello, hello. Welcome back to Exotic Wine Travel. I'm your host, Matthew Horkey. So I'm here on the Paysage Peninsula with a winery that I've heard so much about, and we finally got a chance to visit and taste the wines, and I was completely blown away. I'm here at the Miloš Vinaria with Ivan Miloš. Welcome to the show. Thank you very much for coming.
It's really enjoyable to have you here, and thank you for the compliments of the wine. It means a lot for me. I appreciate it.
Can you talk to a little bit, before we get into your wines specifically, about the culture, the wine culture here on Paysage?
So, as you probably know, the culture of the wine here is pretty big. There is one cave above Orebić, which is one place on this Paleolithic peninsula, where they found the wine tools, which is older than 2,800 years. So the culture and the history of winemaking here is huge, because this peninsula was part of Republic of Dubrovnik, which were always producing wines and olive oil, of course. So we were, my family actually lives in this village almost 500 years. And olive oil winemaking was always part of the life here.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, in the last century, when we had Germanism, it wasn't allowed to have the family-owned business. Everything was owned by government. So it was quite sad times in terms of the quality. But in the late 80s, the communism fell down, luckily, and my father was the first one who established family-owned winery here in this region. And he pushed the boundaries much higher. The level is given much higher. And his first wines was from the 1989 vintage, and then his first Stagnum was in the 90s, and suddenly it became like the first Croatian cult wine, yeah. So the Stagnum wines. The most popular grape here is Plavac Mali, but then there is different appellation of growing it. So we have sticked to this one appellation, so-called Ponikve, mm-hmm. village appellation on this Dolomitic limestone. So it gives us really unique flavors of the vines.
Can you talk about working with Plavac Mali, like what kind of characteristics it gives, the challenges?
Yes, so the Plavac Mali is the grape, it's quite unique variety. If you planted it in the valleys, it gives you the wines which is not so rich, it's really light. In my opinion, it's not good, let's say like that, it's not good at all. But if you plant the Plavac Mali on the southern slopes of the hills, where you have much more sun, where it's different terroir, different soil, you get one of the best wines in Croatia, and don't be modest, let's say in the world almost. But it's really tough to deal with it. Lots of work, it's everything manually farmed, because we need to build those terraces. Mm-hmm. We do, in our family, we do dry farming, we do completely organic approach in the vineyards, so we don't use any pesticides, any chemical fertilizations, everything is organic. So it's a little bit hard, you need to be really patient. For example, for our vineyards, we don't do any harvest until the vines are almost 7-8 years old.
Wow.
So it's really slow process. Yeah. The grape itself has a really small berry. So the Plavac Mali, when you literally translate it, that means something like little the blue one.
Yep.
So the Plavac Mali has the small, really deep color berries and really thick skin. Mm. So it has plenty of tannins. Actually, if you measure it by chemical analysis, it has 3 times more polyphenol compounds, more tannins than the regular red wines on the market.
Wow.
So it's really rich in tannins. And then you need to be really careful when you do vinification process. In our family, we do natural style of winemaking.
Yes.
So it means we do native yeast fermentations, and we follow really long process of aging in big oak casks, in big oak barrels, which is used oak of Slavonia and Croatian oak barrels. So we do at least 3-4 years of aging in the barrels, which is followed by at least 3-4 years of aging in the bottle for the premium wines before we even release them on the market. So it's quite a slow process. You need to be really patient. That's the point.
I really love your philosophy of winemaking, and you know, some of your top wines, your Stagnum from 2003.
That's a premium.
2007 is just it's world class wine, basically.
It's just released 2007, so it's fun to see, you know. Like.
So basically, here at Miloš, they use basically big oak casks, really old school traditional winemaking, fantastic wine. Can you tell us, before we sign off, a little bit more about Miloš, the winery, and what do you see for Miloš going forward in the next few years?
Yes, actually, at the moment, our family has in total like 15 hectares, which is like 37 acres of the vineyards on this premium position, which is one of the biggest family-owned single vineyard. We do completely estate bottle. We use just our own vineyards. In the future, we won't expand so much in the term of the quantities, but we will work hard on the quality, because even we did so much, I think there is so much things to do to progress, because I think my father, he made a name of himself in Croatia, but there is a whole world which should know a little bit more about Plavac, and this is the thing what we are working intensively last 5 years. with my siblings, we managed to export some wines in the States, in Canada, even a little bit in Europe, like Sweden, Switzerland. So we want to spread the word about the Blavats, and what we actually want to show is the grape with strong expression of the terroir, the wines with strong expression of the grape, actually of the Blavats, and a strong expression of the terroir of this unique soil. So we will also, because we planted some new vineyards, we need to see the potential of those new wines. We will probably make even longer aging for some of the labels, not all of them, of course, but some of the labels. We did in the last few years, we did some experiment with barrel aging of more than 6 years of some vintages, which is a really unique thing
you
do.
You release the wines only when they're ready. There's no time.
We don't want to release wines on the market and say to people, wait a little bit, you know. People are not patient. So we did that job for them, you know. We did the aging for them. We did everything. They need just to open the bottles. At least they need to wait for 15 minutes to let it breathe.
Yeah.
All these older wines, you need to decant. My suggestion is always to decant them and then really enjoy. So, because I always say, we put so much history in a single bottle. There is vineyards which is more than 30 years old, almost 10 years of aging, and most people have at least 1 hour of enjoying, you know, like,
yes.
So it's sometimes even it's hard for the people because they live so fast to enjoy, you know, enjoy all that. But we want to give the people a little bit of the culture and history of this area in a single bottle.
Yeah, you have to support wineries like this, real old school winemaking. If you come to Pejasac, come to Dubrovnik, Croatia, stop here at Miloš Winery, buy some wines. They're fantastic.
Well, please, to give me a compliment. That's all I need about the wines.
But Pejasac has been interesting because there's such a big variety in the styles of Plavac Mali, and I'm really impressed here. I have to thank Ivan again because he's got a group waiting for a tour, so we'll sign off. If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel, Exotic Wine Travel. We'll see you at the next episode.
Bye.